What's going on, ball lovers? My name is Jake, and today we're going to be taking a detailed look and performance review on the all-new Adidas Harden Volume 2 and seeing if it lives up to be a worthy successor to the Volume 1. So to kick this review off, the Harden Volume 2's actually come in a black shoebox with the gold Harden logo and Harden written on the side and all that cool stuff, as compared to the Volume 1, which came in the white box. Looks pretty good in my opinion, but what really matters is on the inside. So right when you open the box, something that you'll really notice right off the bat is that the Volume 2's have a much more ergonomic design compared to the Volume 1's, because the Volume 1's took a lot of time to grow on me, whereas these guys, I took them out of the box and I was in love with them. Something that's actually quite unique about these shoes is they feature black boost pellets running along the base. That's something that we're really seeing more of now that Adidas is growing their brand and trying to implement different styles into their shoes, and I really like the way that the black pellets look on this shoe. So we'll kick things off with the fit of the Volume 2, and if you've tried on the Volume 1, you'll know that these guys usually ran a half size big, so you'd have to order a half size down for the shoes to actually fit you, unless you're a wide fitter per se, but the Volume 2's are actually quite different. These guys fit true to size, and I'm a 13, I had to get a 12.5 in the Volume 1's. Volume 2's, I'm a 13, fits perfectly. With that being said, if you are a wide footer, you may need to size up about half a size, but when in doubt, I would go ahead and try on in store. Up until I tried these shoes on, I had yet to find a basketball shoe that I love the fit of as much as I love the fit on these, because they have sort of like a sock-like casing inside that feels like a wetsuit kind of thing, and they're separate from the rest of the shoe, and it really feels like a sock with the way it hugs your foot. Now, if you do take a closer look at the shoes, you'll see the elastic band that joins the mesh material part with the synthetic upper. That is actually quite an elastic band, but it does keep your foot quite locked down in the middle, and it feels like you're nice and snug in these shoes. You're not really going to be going anywhere. So I'd say true to size is your best bet with these guys. Now, going straight into the cushion on these shoes, this is actually the thickest boost we've ever seen on a basketball shoe to date, and it's actually really, really cushioning and comfortable. So the midsoles on the Harden Volume 2's were actually packed with more boost pellets per square inch than most basketball shoes usually have, and that provides more stability when you're on the court, but it also allows for greater impact protection as well. So these guys have got you covered when you're coming down from those big jumps. Despite the fact that these shoes have really, really thick boost, you don't feel like you're floating on the ground when you're on the court. They really still have quite good court feel, and I don't know how the manufacturers at Adidas were able to manage it, but the boost is super thick and you still feel like you're riding right on the ground. Shifting gears into the traction on the Harden Volume 2's, this traction pattern is actually a re-engineered rendition of Harden's data-driven pressure mapped pattern, and it's just as effective as the Volume 1, but it's nothing special or crazy. Some parts of the shoe around the ball of the foot have the rubber spaced very, very, very closely together, so you will have to wipe every now and then to get that dust out of there. But other than that, this shoe performs pretty well on good courts. And also, in terms of durability, this traction pattern and the compound that makes it up make it quite good for outdoor use as well. So if you're looking for a pair of hoop shoes and you've got the money to spend on it, then these guys are really gonna do well for you outdoors. The traction pattern on these guys wasn't lethal by any means, but it definitely provided enough that it wasn't feeling like I was lacking anything out there on the court. In terms of support on the Harden Volume 2's, you can actually see that the boost comes out beyond the edge of the shoe on both the medial and the lateral sides. And it's actually pretty effective at keeping you quite stable and giving you a lot of support on the court, but yet it doesn't feel like you're wearing snowshoes. My biggest initial concern with these shoes was that the upper panel was going to be a lot less rigid than it actually is, and it was going to be too flimsy and not give me as much support on the court, but that's not the case. This guy is actually quite firm, and it surrounds the sock-like material that goes on the inside, and it really gives you a lot more stability around the heel and along the sides, giving you that bit of extra ankle support. I definitely never felt worried about my support at all in these shoes, even though they weren't specifically designed to center around support. The lateral sides actually have this reinforced rubber to help cage the boost on aggressive jab steps, so you don't feel like you're gonna slip off the bed of the shoe. Lastly, the biggest part of this shoe that you've probably already noticed is that the traction pattern actually comes up around the back of the shoe and gives you the added bit of support around the heel to prevent heel slip, and just really protects your Achilles tendon and just makes you feel that much more secure in the back. So I think this feature right here is actually a pretty good addition. So in terms of the materials and the overall style of this shoe, as I said before, I'm in love with it. But going into detail, the mesh on the forefoot really required little to no break-in time whatsoever. And the Volume 2s actually feature cross-stitching on the mesh forefoot that really prevents stretching over time, so these shoes are gonna last you quite a while. This synthetic upper, although it looks flimsy and it might seem flimsy in pictures, believe me, once you get your hands on it, you're gonna realize how tough this stuff is. And I was fearful that somebody might come down on it and tear it, and that's really not the case, because you can see that all this stuff is really durable and really is gonna take a beating out there on the court in case somebody might land on your foot in the wrong angle, because that was my initial worry. But now I can see that that's not gonna happen. I think that the last feature that we have yet to cover on this shoe is probably one of the most obvious, and it's all of the lace loops that you can see along the side of the upper synthetic material. And this is reminiscent of the Adidas Dame 3, which had the same feature where you can put your laces through different loops depending on how you want your lockdown, whether you want it more down to the base of your foot or you like it just over the top of your foot. Just depends on your personal preference, but you can mix and match the designs to your heart's desire, and it really provides a lot of customization options. So lastly, in terms of price, they range from $140 to $150 depending on which colorway you get. This is the California Dreamin' colorway, and they were $150, but that's still pretty reasonable comparing them to the Harden Volume 1, which retailed for $160, and the LS variation. These guys still retail for about $160, while these guys are at $140 and $150, so a better shoe in my opinion, and for a better price. So now that we've reached the end of this performance review, the question still stands: which shoe is better overall, and which shoe I prefer. And after playing in both of these for a little bit of time, I would say that the Harden Volume 2 has the Harden Volume 1 beat on a couple of different aspects. It just feels more flexible, more versatile, feels like it has a little bit more bounce in it. It's definitely got more impact protection with the boost, thicker boost, because you can see the boost on the Volume 1 was there, but not too thick. There's also a bit more ankle protection on the Harden Volume 2s compared to the Harden Volume 1s. And in terms of overall style and the way these shoes look, hard to say, because these are my two favorite colorways on both Volume 1 and Volume 2, and I think the Volume 2 might have it beat, but anyways, that's up to preference. It really just depends on what you like. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video helped you pick out a few key points on the Volume 2, or maybe even the Volume 1 that you like, and maybe you're willing to try it out and really pick it as one of your new hoop shoes, because this is definitely going to be one of my go-tos alongside the PG1s that I have. But with that being said, the PG2s just came out. Should I give them a try? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a huge thumbs up and subscribe for more. Take care, everybody.